Yeah, now I understood it. Thanks for that.
So any further doubts, any questions on how does the star, how does the asterisk or a wildcard works, and what's the use case of using those dot dot? How does that number in search works? So these two basics are going to really super important in going forward sessions. So earlier basics, which were super important, we covered again and again. Addition to that, these two basics, asterisk and a dot dot, is again going to be a super important. Have a thorough understanding of this asterisk and a dot dot. How does it work? So that this will help us in our future session to understand further. Any further doubts? Any follow-up questions, doubts, or anything? Yes, no.
If I have one, if you can go through that Google search query. Mm-hmm.
This one?
Right. But you have not given any, you know, colon for this one. This 2013, you know, dot dot, and 2015.
See, colon there is no need when you're trying to capture the entire phrase.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, when I'm trying to capture just the number range, I wouldn't even need a colon. Anything between 2013 to 2015.
Okay.
If you're trying to capture some the entire phrase, let's say software space engineer, if I'm trying to capture that entire phrase, that's where I'm using colon. Now here also, we are using colon. We're trying to capture the entire phrase. This is one Boolean, and 1000 dot dot 5000 is Boolean in Boolean again. So double quote is the first Boolean operator for sure. Under that also, 1000 dot dot 5000 is second Boolean operator. It's a Boolean in Boolean operator.
Okay.
In this example, I don't need, it's straightforward, 2013 to 2015.
Okay, sure. And
so in double quotes, now what will happen if you keep in double quotes? It might try to understand that dot dot not as a Boolean operator, but as an additional keyword. It will take the entire phrase, okay, 2013 dot dot 2015 within the double quotes. So it gives 2018 results. Let's remove double quotes from here. Sorry, not here. So it might misunderstand also sometimes. So 218. Anyways, now it's accurate, but otherwise it might misunderstand also. In case if any word exists in between, then it might say, okay, fine, the person is trying to search for the phrase. And then it would take it as an entire keyword as a phrase. It wouldn't take it as an operator. The way it's taking it as an operator, 1000 dot dot 5000 contribution, the entire phrase we're trying to search. Here we don't have a phrase at all. We don't have any words before or after that. 2013, 2015. It's pretty straightforward. So that's the reason we are not using any other word before or after, and just kept it within the double quotes. So it's just straightforward. I don't have any word after or before this. Yeah, you were telling something.
Yeah, one more point was, you know, like github.//. You know, if you look at for, you know, monitoring, you know, if you're looking other for URL, you know, what are the, you know, like gray and dark, you know, fields. So that forward slash also is there for GitHub.
Just so GitHub.com is enough. No need of forward slash. See, okay. Forward slash when we need, when we have some of the examples where the second folder is existing. In GitHub, we don't have a second folder. It's immediately github.com/username. But in some of the examples previously, what we have seen in previous examples,
top tail, you know, top.
Wait a second. Yesterday only we had some examples. Like script.com developer, there is an additional folder existing after that. So unless this additional folder is not existing, we don't need this forward slash and this thing. So after that, it's pretty much open-ended. We can exclude that forward slash. So where were
God issues?
yesterday you shared one example, right? We did not take that.
Correct.
Okay, in there, in that 2-3 folders were existing. So you have taken up to those 2-3 folders. But here, okay, let's say in this example also, site linkedin.com / in is for individual profiles. And that's the reason we are mentioning up to /. But after / in also, we have a individual profile URL name. Shivkumar-Gurram and all. We have that one. But why we need? It's pretty much open-ended. This also would give. So here it is github.com / immediately username. If it would have been a profile / something, then I would go github.com / profile / I'll keep it open because there is a username existing. But if it is immediately username, there is no folder for that particular username, then we can go directly with the github.com /.
Got it, Shiv.
All right. Any further doubts, questions on dot, dot, or a star, asterisk? Clear?
I'm confused, actually.
Yeah?
I am confused, still confused.
Okay.
Can you see the I sent you in chat? Maybe you can explain it.
Okay. Now in this, what you have done, site github.com C# Noida. So instead of 2017-2021, just give dot, dot. So this 2017-, so it's taking as it is. But as soon as you convert 17 dot, dot, you get more results. So whatever people who would have joined or anything, 14 to 18 or whatever the text they would have mentioned.
Got it.
What is dot, dot stands for, Shiv?
Dot, dot is...
It's a Boolean.
Huh? Dot, dot is number range. You can use between two different numbers.
Is this the only optimization we can do, or we can do further optimization on this?
Not many optimizations. That's what I'm saying. Focus on basics, a URL pattern, a page pattern. So, okay, let's say this part. We would say now site github.com to give the individual profiles. Goldman Sachs, 4 followers. Okay. Followers we covered. Block or report. So we used this part also. Let's now use this part. Block or report. Site github.com, block or report. And then let's say gmail.com. Anyways, Java. Or Bangalore. Okay. So site github.com, block or report part, Java, Bangalore, or Bangalore. We got some 14,000 profiles. All individual profiles again. Because we have used that one particular pattern of block or report, which is there only on individual profiles. It's not there on repositories or anything. Now after opening, okay, fine. I got it. Okay, only one contribution. No contribution in past so many years. I don't want this profile. I want it. At least 500 contribution, 14 contributions. No, I don't want this profile. I wanted someone who is hands-on. I'll just take this part. We'll say, okay, fine. Let's add this part now. Now from, I need someone who have at least 500 contributions minimum up to 5,000 contributions. So now we got the list of results. Who has more than 500 contributions? Earlier we got the result who has no contribution or 10, 15, 10, 20 contributions. But now we have almost all the results, which has more than 500 contributions. So this is, sorry. So here, 2000 plus contributions. So we gave 500 dot dot 5000. So we got it this one. 600 plus. 542 plus. 800 plus. 2000 plus. 500 plus. 500 plus. So that's a number range search. So, yeah. Any more doubts on number range or what does that star do? Because again, these two basics are going to play a major role again. Addition to the previous basics, these two additional basics. Yes, no, good, bad, confused.
Looks
the meaning of this contribution number. Anju, just get the understanding of dot dot and asterisk. About the contribution, I would cover in detail session of GitHub when we do the GitHub sessions. So we have a specifically GitHub sessions designed in future. So that is pretty much covered. I would cover completely in-depth GitHub session. That time you can ask any feature related to GitHub. For now, just try understanding what star is doing and what dot dot is doing. Otherwise, sourcing from GitHub, direct and indirect, it's pretty much there. There we'll go help you understand what is GitHub page, what is GitHub job page, individual page, what is repositories, what is contribution, what is project, everything in detail.
You're right, Shraj, otherwise we'll get confused with this.
For now, only think about what is dot dot doing and star is doing. Don't think anything else. Try to understand the basics.
Okay.
So what does dot dot does?
Dot dot is a range between the two numbers, 2 to 5 years, 2000.
It could be anything. It could be year, it could be number, it could be inch, it could be height, it could be weight, it could be anything. So when you give that dot dot between two numbers, we would get that numbers in our search results. What is star? It's a fill in the blanks. That's simple.
If it's not funny, Shiv, can we use star for numbers also? Means ranging from, say, 2010 to 2021.
True. Okay. But when we have dot dot operator specifically designed for numbers, why would need star, which are designed for the keywords?
Got it.
Star is designed for the keyword. Okay. So you can cut a cake, okay, with the axe also. Okay, but you can't cut a tree with a knife.
Understood.
So it's like that. So can you cut a cake with an axe? Yes, you can cut a cake with an axe. But is it designed to cut a cake? No, it's designed to cut a tree. So it's like that. Any further doubts? So it's not a strategic answer, but in factually, if I need to help you understand, not so immediately, it will confuse you more, but going forward. So for now, that's the reason I'm saying, try to understand the basic of star, what star is doing, what it's meant for. It's meant for keyword, and it's basically replacing any of the keywords which are being given between the two words, like SAP space star space developer. So what this star is doing in between, it's giving us all the results which has that word, maybe ABAP developer or web Dynamics developer or whatever the kind of a developer. So positioning of SAP and what we say developer remains as it is, first SAP and last developer. But where is that? Did we? Okay. So SAP in the beginning and developer at the last, because we had given in the double quotes. That's reason SAP positioning remains as it is in the first and developer as it is in last. But whatever the words are coming in between is been replaced by that particular star. That's the star is doing. Can I use it immediately with develop and star so that I will get develop, developer, developing, developed and all? Answer is yes or no. Sometimes it's working. Sometimes it's not working. Google is doing something with that algo. Soon you might experience the differences, but for now, the answer is yes or no. So they might keep it, they might remove it. But if you see between two words, if you're using, when we have a space before and after asterisk, it's working perfectly fine. But that's the reason I mentioned. Does the asterisk works with the combination of keyword immediately? For example, test star, soft star. The answer is yes and no, both based on the various use case. Hence, it's always suggested to try various searches while using a asterisk. However, it perfectly works fine when there is a space before and after asterisk and been used to replace any keyword. Something like example, something like this, or something like test star, so that it would get test manager, test management, test development, or anything like that. What is dot dot search? It's basically a number range search. It searches between any two number. So for example, 3.6 inches or 3.6 foot or 3.6 feet or 2015.2019, whatever it is. So just get the basics of it. So slowly, once we advance to the advanced sessions, then you can connect all the dots and try to understand why those basics were needed. And then come up with the most optimal strengths. All right. Any further doubts, communication, doubts or anything?
Thanks.
On dot, dot and star?
Clear, Chef.
Dinesh, Madhusudan, Neeraj, Parmeshwari, Sharma, Satish, Shweta.
Okay.
Understood, sir.
No, Chef.
No, okay. No, Chef.
Good?
Good.
Okay. Whoever has missed previous two session, I'll upload the recordings tonight. I would strongly recommend to go through those videos. Tomorrow and after tomorrow, we'll have a break just for you to cover those videos. And then again, we'll restart. Or at least one day break is needed. Just go through those videos, do a little bit of practice, and try to understand what has been covered, which is really important for going forward sessions, which was more of definitely around asterisk only, and how to identify various sites. Basically, this is image and face searches. Why it is important in future, you'll come to know, but try to get the basics clear around Google Face and Google Image searches. Asterisk, Google Image, Google Face, and dot, dot. Once these four things are clear, then we can move forward. So tomorrow we'll take a 1 day gap. I'll upload these videos today itself. Including today, last three sessions videos to be uploaded. Today itself, I'll upload. Just go through those videos once more. If you have already gone through, if you have not gone through, please go through that, get that basic stuff clear, and then we'll move forward to the next stage day after tomorrow. Anything between, if you have any doubt while watching a videos or anything, please free to ping me on a WhatsApp. Personally, I'll be able to respond.
Okay, sure.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
All right. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks,
thank everyone. You so much.
That's it for today. No problem.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sure.
Thank you. Bye. Have a great day. Hope everyone had a great new year as well. Yes, no.
Yes.
Okay. Take care. Bye-bye.